Yeah, this is sort of an unboxing video. This is a new coffee maker, and I like the Moulinex brand. His spouse was just here. He thinks I'm crazy. I'm always making clips. Okay, I'm putting the camera down again. Okay, there it is, and the box will be... He's really good at breaking these things down and putting them in the correct recycling bins. Comes with a guarantee and a detailed instruction book. I love reading instruction manuals. I always read them. I'm a total nerd. And this is in many languages. And the old Moulinex coffee maker that we have, which his parents bought us, 20 plus years ago, when we first bought this apartment and moved here. It's a little dim in here, and I'm not opening the window, the shutter right by the front of the apartment here. It's afternoon, it's siesta time in late July, so I'm not opening it. The old one finally died, and I thought it was very strange because I kept, you know, filling up the water thing, and I was always cleaning it with white vinegar and stuff, and occasionally running the pieces, which were washable, through the dishwasher. And we got over 20 years out of it. It's a good little machine. I don't drink coffee, really, but he has a cup of it cold or hot in the morning, a mug. And that's it. He won't drink anymore for the rest of the day. And I noticed a couple of times that half the water was missing when I looked again, because I usually got it ready at night when needed. And I thought, what is this, you know, vanishing water? And then last night I got it all ready. I put the chicory in and the regular coffee and even a dash of cinnamon, which he doesn't care about. And this morning there was no water in there. And I noticed yesterday in our kitchen here, and I've got to scrub this floor again today. Kind of a battered kitchen at this point. This custom kitchen is from 97. See, there's a wet paper towel and a wet rag down here. Ugh! I've got to pick this up and throw this out and put the tea towel, very old tea towel with holes in it, in the machine. I had noticed for the past few days, amid this clutter, that there seemed to be some stains on the floor. And then last night, see, here are some more. I really saw some water there. There's a mouse trap in there. And I thought, oh no, I'm going to have to annoy the husband and leave him a message, and he's going to go nuts that there is some sort of leak in this wall. And this is an apartment from the 60s, which has heating tubes in the ceiling and floor of most of the apartment. Not all of it, most of it. So this is the only room which can have a ceiling fixture, is the kitchen. I don't think that this room is heated, but I'm not sure. The architect is still here. He lives upstairs. And I thought, thought, oh God, the wall's going to have to be broken. I paid a lot of money. It was a huge mess to have this whole wall broken down and redone in 2010. And the idiot who was here from the United States, yeah, he vacuumed up the dust, but he yanked the vacuum cleaner around so badly right after he left, the hose just, it was all torn. Idiot. You know, you don't do that. You don't yank a vacuum cleaner around by the hose. I mean, everybody knows that. Everybody except dim-witted perverts with single-digit IQs from the USA. And I realized this morning, oh no. So I made the last pot of coffee here, and ooh, this usually sits here for a few days. He just takes it cold in the morning. He doesn't want it reheated. If I do want coffee in the warm weather, I will not hesitate to put this in the blender with ice cubes and make a sort of iced coffee, or just pour it over ice cubes and put some raw sugar in it or something like that. So this is kind of the damage. I have to clean the floor again. Well, it needs cleaning anyway. Okay.